In this presentation, we'll be talking about depreciation tools that apply to farms and ranches. Basically, the depreciation rules, we're going to look at the 2017 rules as per the 2017 tax laws. We'll talk about different options available, and then we'll discuss how depreciation can be used as an income tax management tool. So depreciation, basically, what is depreciable? That's the purchase of new or used machinery, equipment, vehicles, breeding livestock, dairy livestock, draft livestock, buildings, any other farm assets with a useful life greater than 1 year. So depreciation, what we're doing is deducting the cost of using a piece of property over its useful life. Now there's a difference with tax depreciation versus book depreciation or actual depreciation. Tax depreciation is much faster and typically will not coincide to exactly the machine's useful life, but it does allow for a depreciable reduction in that asset at a much faster rate, which is good for tax management purposes. Normally, you cannot deduct 100% of the cost in the first year the asset is placed in service, but in one circumstance we can, and we'll explain that in a moment. So depreciation methods. Rules currently that we work with are under the Modified Accelerated Cost Recovery System. We have what they call the general depreciation system, which is normal, accelerated, or straight line options for depreciating an item. And we have also the alternate depreciation system, which is a straight line over a longer depreciable life of an asset. Also have the Section 179 deduction, Section 179 expensing, also referred to as expensing election. What this is the ability to recover all or part of the cost in the year an asset is placed in service within certain limits. So we're looking at newer used item here, and as long as our total deduction doesn't create a loss, we can take a deduction up to the full cost of that item. The third item that we have currently still exists. It was brought in 2008. It's been adjusted. But if you look at it, it's called additional first year depreciation, also referred to as bonus depreciation. On a new asset placed in service, it has to be new, has to be purchased. New asset placed in service, 50% of the cost can be written off for 2016 and 2017 tax years. Beginning in 2018, 40% of that item can be written off in the year of purchase, and it goes to 30% in 2019. And unless something changes in the tax law, in 2020 it completely disappears. So it is repealed, sunsets in the year 2020. So the MACRS depreciation methods, how does this work? We have what they call a general depreciation system. And that's 200% declining balance, but it only applies to non-farm property. So if you have a non-farm business, you can take 200% declining balance. So a very rapid write-off. But for farm, we're required to use the 100 for 50% declining balance. This applies to all farm property. So consequently, it's a little slower, but there are some benefits of doing so, and those have to do with taking care of pre-productive period expenses, which we're not going to discuss much in here. If you want more information on that, go to the Farmer's Tax Guide. So the 150% declining balance applies to farm property. Under that system, you have the straight line method as well as the rapid write-off for declining balance. Then we have the ADS method, which is that longer life recovery period. All of these, we depreciate the asset to zero, fully deducting the cost of the asset over that period of time. The 179 rules has to be depreciable property in order to be subject to the 179 or be allowed to use the 179 deduction. So it has to be depreciable, has to be acquired for business use, must be purchased, not leased, can be either new or used. Now the bonus depreciation requires new, 179, new or used. And the amount allowed, these are these limits. So if you look at the amount allowed, it cannot exceed $2 limits. For 2016, $500,000 of machinery and equipment Placed in service, you could write off. As long as we did not invest more than $2,010,000 in property. If you devoted more or paid more than that, invested more than that, then we start losing. For each dollar above that $2.01 million, we lose a dollar of Section 179 write-off. 2017, adjusted for inflation, we can place $510,000 of property in service, write it completely off, as long as we do not invest more than $2,030,000 in property. Now, if the investment limit is exceeded, like I said before, then the amount allowed to be expensed is reduced $1 for each dollar above that investment limit. It cannot create a business loss, but any unused amount can be carried forward to future tax years. So if we have $100,000 of business income, net income from the farm, we can write off using 179 up to that $1 million. If we have W-2 income as well, so if we have non-farm wages, then we can increase that amount by the amount of W-2 income. So we can use more than just business income and reduce that for the 179 rules. However, it cannot create a business loss in excess of W-2 income and net business income. Now, 179 rules works well in abnormally high taxable income years. You can write off a lot of investment very quickly. Also works well when the future income is going to be less than this high income year, back to normal. So let's look at the depreciation rules, kind of get an idea of what this thing looks like. So the reason we call it rapid write-off for declining balance, if you look at the blue line, in the first 3 years on 5-year property, we write off a considerable amount of the income. So we take 15% versus 10% in first year when we compare a straight line to declining balance. In the second year, 20% is what's allowed for straight line for years 2 through 5. Then it drops back down in the sixth year. So really, if you look at really what we're being written off, and the depreciation for declining balance, you take a lot of the depreciation in the first 2 years, and then it declines below what would be allowed in years 3 through 6. The same thing with a 7-year property. You get the majority of the depreciation in years 1 through 3 on the declining balance method, whereas at the end, it's much below the straight line method. So from a planning point of view, if we've got large income, we expect income to be down in the future, use the declining balance methods. Get the deduction up front. If we expect higher income in future years versus the current year, straight line method works better. So let's look at a $150,000 tractor to get an idea of what the annual depreciation would be allowed under the declining balance method and the straight line. So you look at the third and fifth columns here. The annual depreciation amount, first year $16,000 compared to the straight line of $10,700. So you can kind of see how this thing declines, how rapidly. And you can see that in years 4 through 7, really 8, our amount of depreciation written off using the declining balance method is much less than the straight line method. That's the reason why I say if your income is high in the year that we purchase the asset and in future years, use the declining balance method, you get a greater write-off, greater tax benefit. Now, so it's a tax management tool, depreciation, very useful, very easy to use tool to manage taxable income. It's just a piece of machinery or equipment. You really need to have equipment that is needed in the business. Don't just be buying it because we want to. So then if we look at taxable income, if it's expected to stay the same or increase, use straight line to maintain a larger deduction in those future high income years. If taxable income is expected to decline, use the declining balance depreciation to capture the larger deduction in the early or high income years. So here we got another asset looking at it. But here we are applying Section 179 rules. So you can kind of compare what happens. So if we've got 150% declining balance, straight line, the 179 rules on that $40,000 piece of equipment, we write it all off in year 1 using 179. You write off $4,000 in first year under normal annual depreciation straight line, $6,150 declining balance. So again, looking at it from a management point of view, tax management point of view, if you've got income that's normally high this year and going back to normal next year, the 179 rules work very well. Straight line or declining balance, again, depending upon what future is going to be, if you expect it to be high in the upcoming first few years, use declining balance. If you expect it to be pretty even, then use the straight line rules. Now, I didn't put in here the bonus depreciation, but what bonus does is takes that $40,000 piece of equipment. So if you use 150% declining balance, we'll have $20,000 plus the $6,000 that's allowed in year one if we use 150% declining balance. It'd be $20,000 plus the $4,000, so $24,000 in the first year if we use a straight line method, and then you just reduce those other numbers accordingly. Now, the tax savings that are applied. So what we've got here is looking at taxable income and applying the different depreciation deductions to kind of get an idea of what the tax savings would be. So if you look at then taxable income under the 150% declining balance, straight line 179, all the same, $75,300. Our deductible amount for depreciation purposes, $6,000, $4,000, $42,250. You can see at the very bottom, the tax savings is much greater if we have Section 179 rules applying in that first year. Again, remember, you don't get any future debt tax deduction. Straight line, 753 compared to 1053 for the declining balance. So again, here's how that tax management comes into play. Looking at what this year is, comparing it to what we think future years are going to do. It requires the use or planning from your tax preparer to kind of give you some better help of what's going on so that you know exactly what's taking place. And by good planning, proper planning, it is very easy to save quite a few tax dollars. So in conclusion here, depreciation ops, simple, most frequently used tax management tool. It's very easy to apply. However, you have to be careful. What happens, we get to where we want to minimize our tax bite to the extreme point. We use the 179, we use depreciation, we overinvest in machine equipment. This often leads to cash flow problems if we experience low economic times or low economic returns to the farm. So it can hurt us in the future years. Also, be sure to consult with your tax advisor to determine your best tax management options. Always much easier to avoid a problem than it is to fix a mistake. There's also a website called ruletax.org. This website has a variety of tax topics on depreciation, depreciation rules, a great place to start for, again, current, easy to understand information.